Welcome to the recess meeting.
Of the Will County Board for April 18, 2013. We'll call this meeting to order. If everyone would please rise, we'll have the County Board member Reed Bible lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance this morning and then introduce our clergy.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. President, at this time, would the Reverend Lishers Mahone Jr. of Brown Chapel AME of Joliet please come forward for the invocation?
Let us pray. O Lord our God, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. The very heavens declare your glory. So we give you all honor, all glory, and all praises, for you and you alone are worthy to be praised. For this day, in the fullness of your grace and mercy, your loving kindness that you poured out upon each one of us, we thank you for it. For the opportunity that we might, first of all, fellowship one with the other, and then unite ourselves for the purpose of taking care of the business in which you have charged us with the responsibility of. So we ask your blessings upon this board, that you would give them the sight, insight, and foresight, that they might not only look upon things, but look into things, and have the wisdom and the knowledge and the understanding to make adjustments where it's needed, and also to serve this present age. We pray that you would continue to bless them and keep them by the power of your might. And when they face the midnight challenges of running the government of this county, that you would be there to direct them, instruct them, and keep them. We know that all things can work together for good. We pray for this nation, in spite of all of the destructive activities that's going on, that you would simply allow us to know that you still have the whole world in the very palms of your hands. So keep us, direct us, pour out your mercy, your grace upon us. We thank you in advance for it, for we ask it all in the blessed name of Jesus. Amen.
Madam Clerk, will you please call the roll?
Sure. Zagrosi?
Here.
Mustis?
Here.
Howard?
Here.
Ogala?
Here.
Izzo?
Here.
Moran?
Here.
Rice?
Here.
Harris?
Here.
Trainier?
Here.
Bible?
Here.
Goodson?
Here.
Freitag?
Here.
Gould?
Here.
Balich?
Here.
Frisalone?
Here.
Winfrey?
Here.
Adamick?
Here.
Babich?
Here.
Wilhelmy?
Here.
Hart? Mayor? McDermott?
Here.
Weigel,
here.
Collins,
here.
Ferry,
here.
And Brooks.
Here.
Thank you.
24 members present, 2 members absent.
24 members present, a quorum has been established. Entertain a motion to place on file the certificate of publication. Moved by Mr. Wilhelmy, second by Mr. Ferry. Madam Clerk, call the roll, please.
Sure. Zagrosi?
Yes.
Mustis? Howard?
Yes.
Ogallala?
Yes.
Izzo?
Yes.
Moran?
Yes.
Rice?
Yes.
Trainier?
Yes.
Bible?
Yes.
Goodson?
Yes.
Freitag?
Yes.
Gould?
Yes.
Balich?
Yes.
Rizalone?
Yes.
Winfrey?
Yes.
Adamek?
Yes.
Babich?
Yes.
Wilhelmie?
Yes.
McDermott?
Yes.
Weigel?
Yes.
Collins?
Yes.
Ferry?
Yes.
And Brooks?
Yes.
Thank you.
24 affirmative, motion has carried. Entertain a motion to approve the minutes of our March 21st, 2013 meeting. Moved by Mr. Adamek, second by Ms. Rice. Any questions? Previous roll call by Mrs. Grossi, second by Ms. McDermott. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried. Madam Clerk, would you please acknowledge our elected officials and the media that is present this morning?
Sure. Circuit Clerk Pam McGuire, County Clerk Nancy Schultz-Foots, our County Executive Larry Walsh, Sheriff Paul Copas, State's Attorney James Glasgow, and we have a special guest in the audience, our Mayor of Manuka, Pat Brennan. And media, we have Nick Ryer from Farmers Weekly and Bugle, Rex Robinson, The Times Weekly, Monica O'Brien from WJOL, and Nick Jakus.
I got it right this time.
From WJOL. Welcome.
It's nice to see Monica back around here.
Yes.
So, thank you, Nancy.
You're welcome.
Citizens to be heard, and we do have some citizens that have signed up, and will be heard at the appropriate time. And I think our first honorary resolution and proclamation, County Board
and Blitz Collins will present a proclamation supporting text-free driving. Ms. Collins?
I'll just do it from right here.
That'll be fine.
April is National Distracted Driving Awareness Month, and on your desk, you'll each find a text-free driving pledge. I just thought this would fit in with the public health and safety committee that I was assigned to. But a few statistics about driving while texting.
Liz, would you pull your mic to your...
Is, a few statistics about driving while texting is it makes a person 23 times more likely to crash. It's like driving after having four beers. Taking your eyes off the road for an average of 5 seconds at 55 miles an hour is like driving the length of a football field completely blind. Car crashes kill an average of 11 teens every day. It injures 330,000 people every year. It's dangerous and life-threatening to the driver, others in the car, and everyone else on the road. On January 1st of 2010, Illinois enacted a law which prohibits drivers from texting. The sole purpose of reporting an emergency situation and continued communication with emergency personnel during the emergency situation. These are the exceptions. Using a device in a hands-free or voice-activated mode. If the driver is parked on the shoulder of a roadway, or when the vehicle is stopped due to normal traffic being obstructed and the driver has the vehicle in neutral or park. So I just want to encourage you and your family members to take the text-free driving pledge. All the county board members have a copy of it on their desk. And I also have some thumb bands. If you can't remember and you get in your car and you're texting, this will just remind you to not do it while you're driving. Thank you.
You want to make a motion to accept that?
And I make a motion to accept this proclamation.
So moved by Ms. Collins, second by Ms. Goodson. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion has carried. Our state's attorney, Jim Glasgow, isn't here yet. The presentation of a check from Waste Management we will take on later in the agenda. So, with that, all resolutions from the March 21st, 2013 County Board agenda have been signed by the County Executive. Moving on into new business, first committee, our Land Use and Development Committee, Mr. Tom Weigel, Chairman.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Tom.
First item is a public hearing. I'll make a motion to open the public hearing for land use cases.
Moved by Mr. Weigel, second by Ms. Collins. Madam Clerk, call the roll, please.
Sure. Zagrozzi?
Yes.
Mustis?
Yes.
Howard?
Yes.
Ogallala?
Yes.
Izzo?
Yes.
Moran?
Yes.
Rice?
Yes.
Harris?
Yes.
Trainier?
Yes.
Bible?
Yes.
Goodson?
Yes.
Freitag?
Yes.
Gould?
Yes.
Balich?
Yes.
Frisalone?
Yes.
Winfrey?
Yes.
Adamek? Babich?
Yes.
Wilhelmie?
Yes.
McDermott?
Yes.
Weigel?
Yes.
Collins?
Yes.
Ferry?
Yes.
And Brooks?
Yes.
Thank you.
24 affirmative.
24 affirmative. We are in public hearing. Please be advised that absolutely no evidence or information will be allowed once this land use public hearing is closed. Today, we have case number 6095-SV9, 6096-S, 6097-S, 6100-S, and 6101-S. We have a number of people that have signed up already. And our first one is Mr. Corey Linhart. Mr. Corey Linhart, would you like to speak or only if necessary? Thank you very much. Next, we have Mr. Michael Martin. Mike, only if necessary. Thank you very much, Michael. And that's, I guess, it.
That's it.
Is there anyone else from the public that wishes to speak on any of these zoning cases? Anyone wishing to speak? Last question, anyone wishing to speak on any of these zoning cases? Mr. Weigel.
I would make a motion to close the public hearing.
Motion made by Mr. Weigel, second by Mr. Izzo. Madam Clerk, call the roll.
Sure. Zagrozzi?
Yes.
Mustis?
Yes.
Howard?
Yes.
Ogallala?
Yes.
Izzo?
Yes.
Moran?
Yes.
Rice?
Yes.
Harris?
Yes.
Trainier?
Yes.
Bible?
Yes.
Goodson?
Yes.
Freitag?
Yes.
Gould?
Yes.
Balich?
Yes.
Frisalone?
Yes.
Winfrey?
Yes.
Adamek?
Yes.
Babich?
Yes.
Wilhelmie?
Yes.
McDermott?
Yes.
Weigel?
Yes.
Collins?
Yes.
Ferry?
Yes.
And Brooks?
Yes.
Thank you.
24 affirmative.
Public hearing has been closed. Mr. Weigel, please continue.
Our first case is 6095-SV9. This concerns a special use permit for a cargo container storage and maintenance facility on parcel 1 and 2 with 8 conditions. This is in an industrial area off New Avenue in DuPage Township. Committee recommends approval, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Weigel. Second by Mr. Adamek. Any questions? Previous roll by Ms. Izzo, second by Ms. Trainier. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
Next case, 6096-S. This is a special use permit for a sports and recreation facility in an industrial building in New Lenox Township with 2 conditions. It has I-1 zoning. Committee recommends approval, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Weigel, second by Mr. Frisalone. Any previous roll call by Mr. Babich, second by Mr. Wilhelmie. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
Next case, 6097S, is a special use permit for recreational vehicles, park RV campground. This is an existing campground they want to expand in Troy Township near the Speedway, or I'm sorry, this is near Interstate 89-55. With the 6 conditions, committee recommends approval, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Weigel, second by Ms. McDermott. Any questions? Previous roll by Mr. Adamek, second by Mr. Moran. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion has carried.
Next case, 6100-S, a special use permit for overnight tent and pop-up camping in Joliet Township near the Speedway. with four conditions. It's an existing campground, but they're changing some of the tents and pop-ups. Committee recommends approval, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Weigel, second by Ms. Freitag. Any questions? Previous roll call by Ms. Winfrey, second by Mr. Babbage. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
The next case, 6101-S, special use permit for a private recreation club in Wheatland Township. This is on 119th Street. This has 12 conditions. This is for use of soccer fields. Previously, they had temporary use permits for this facility. Committee recommends approval, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Weigel, second by, who did I hear a second from? Gould. You threw me off there, Donnie. Sorry. Moved by Mr. Weigel, second by Mr. Gould. Any questions? Previous roll call by Ms. Winfrey, second by Ms. Trainier. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
Next is the resolutions, 13-87. This is the Cool County resolution. At our caucus this morning, there were a lot of questions about it, and they wanted more detailed information. They wanted to send it back to committee, and they also have a full board presentation so that they could ask questions and have additional information about it. So I would make a motion to send it back to committee.
Moved by Mr. Weigel, second by Mr. Balich. Any questions? Question, Mr. Mustis.
Yeah, I did talk to Mr. Paddock after our caucus this morning, and he did explain to me that this was the only thing that the intent is to only include things that we've already adopted. Even though I do still think it's a good idea to get a full presentation, but if Mr. Paddock might want to say a few words to clear up any misunderstandings, because when you look up these types of initiatives, like you Google it, there's all types of initiatives under that same heading of you know, cool counties or cool environmental issues. So I don't know if Mr. Paddock wants to say
a few words. Mr. Paddock, would you like to come forward and either try and do your best to explain what the initiative is? Thank you.
The matter before the board, of course, is Resolution 13-87 that's in your packet under Land Use and Development Committee Resolutions. As you know, over the past, it's getting close to almost 4 years now, the county board has been involved in a number of initiatives to work on energy conservation throughout the county, both with respect to the operations of the county itself, as well as a variety of ways to assist other municipalities, community organizations, private sector business in their efforts to become more energy efficient. Those types of initiatives, again, as you know, have increasingly been receiving recognition both at the state level with our receipt of the Governor's Sustainability Award, invitations to a number of national meetings, and in some instances actually international recognition of the work that Will County has been doing in this field. Well, another group that was proud of the fact that this county has been taking some steps in this area came to us and said, we know that as a part of the board adopted energy conservation plan, that the board recognized that if we're going to move this particular county agenda forward, that we'll need the cooperation and the participation of a wide number of community groups, the private sector, individual citizens. This is clearly not something that government can or should do on its own. So we need the help and cooperation of community groups. Cool Joliet is one such group that came to the county and said, you know, we know all the great things that you're already doing. We think that they represent the kind of direction and effort that's consistent with our goals and agenda, and we want to partner with you. And we'd like to do that in a way where you would have the county pass a resolution that would indicate that you were affiliating with us under the umbrella, under the recognition program that's called Cool Counties. So if you look at the text of the actual ordinance that's, or beg your pardon, resolution that's before you, it simply enumerates those activities which this board has already adopted and authorized in terms of policies and programs related to the wide issue of energy conservation, energy efficiency, and other related initiatives as embodied in our energy conservation plan, our land resource management plan, our solid waste plan, all of these which were adopted by with considerable discussion, debate, public input by this board. So, in summary, it's always good to know exactly what you're voting on. So if the matter needs to be referred back to committee for refinement of the language, that's great. But the intent is clearly here not to adopt the agenda of any other organization, but simply to enumerate what are those things that we're currently doing and recognize that a community organization wants to affiliate and work with us on our agenda to carry out an energy efficiency and energy conservation agenda.
Mr. Musis, question?
I do think we should send it back, Mr. Paddock. I understand your intent. I'm not so sure that clearly comes through in this resolution. So I do think we should probably refine the resolution to clearly state what we're supporting here. So so I do think we should send it back. But I didn't want to give you the opportunity to say the intent was just to really emphasize what we've already adopted in our ordinances and our various policies on clean energy and so forth. So so I still think it should probably go back just to be clearly more clearly stated.
Mr. Balich.
When you bring it back to the board, I would like it clearly spelled out whether you whether this promotes initiatives like smart meters and extra taxes on fossil fuels, elimination of coal. You know, I want that actually spelled out in the resolution. I don't want to see something that's vague that can be interpreted in the wrong way.
Right. Good. But that'll be discussed in the context of the committee's deliberations.
Mr. Howard.
Again, I think I'm going to resonate on what was said here also, but I think the initial fear was at the land use is when it was presented was basically that this is endorsing or going to implement measures that save energy in the future, but to the homeowner it might cost them a substantial amount now. And the lifespan of a human being is 70 years old, and some of this stuff you'll have to live to be 130 to realize the actual cost saving of it. So I think that maybe that wasn't the purpose of this, but some people actually left that with that feeling that this was basically a pathway or it's going to grease the skids to additional restrictions on building, restrictions on homeowners' rights,
right,
as far as that. And,
right.
And I think I know, Kurt, we had that discussion there.
Yeah.
So if we could alleviate that, I think that would be a good thing now that we are going to listen to the presentation again on it. So thank you.
I think one of the ways that could help be relieved is the structure of the resolution refers to various board adopted plans that have very specific language about what this board supports and what it doesn't support. So if one has a fear on this subject, I believe that fear could be alleviated by looking at the policy documents that the board has already adopted and seeing that none of those things that are feared are contained within them.
Mr. Frizzalone.
Well, I think some of the confusion may come because we're calling it the Illinois Cool Counties, and if you Google that, it leads you to Illinois Cool Cities, and they have a whole set of directives which are not part of what we're looking at.
Yeah, and so I think that's the language that Mr. Musis has suggested that would be refined in the context of the committee's deliberation before it came back to the board to make it more explicitly clear, as I said, that this is about an organization recognizing and wishing to be affiliated with the Will County agenda not the notion of Will County endorsing or being supportive or completely on board with the agenda of some other organization. So that clarity could be achieved, I'm sure.
Mr. Brooks?
Well, I just think that Will County ought to be cool. So therefore, I believe it was suggested that we send it back to your committee, Mr. Weigel, so that there's a presentation you're recommending so they can better explain, Kurt, what you're explaining to us. The language is a little more defined. We definitely want to be known as a cool county, so I think if that's what it takes, we need to get a better understanding so that I recommend also that it go back to committee for better discussion. Mm-hmm. I would like to be there to hear that presentation as well, because I always wanted to be cool.
Mr. Izzo?
Kurt, can you just make sure you have one question answered for us at that next meeting as to how many other counties besides Cook are involved in this program? That's all I ask.
There's one. It's DuPage.
Out of 101 count?
100? Not Cook.
Okay. Just DuPage?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Any last questions? Mr. Radomich?
Thank you, Mr. Executive. Mr. Executive, I think Kurt Paddock has stated this quite succinctly. This is stuff that we've already endorsed and are doing. Who can be against educating people on reducing energy usage? Who can be against trying to provide local grown food? Who can be against trying to develop energy efficient building techniques? I mean, these are things that we're already doing, and I don't know what the controversy is, but if it takes to get everybody on board, I guess we can send it back to committee, but I will be supporting this. It just seems to make sense. I mean, if we don't take care of this birdcage called Earth and we keep trapping it up, it's not about us. It's about the future generations that come after us. It's not about me or you or anybody else in this room. It's about our kids and their kids. And if we don't try to take care of this Earth, we will be in a desperate straits. So,
Thank you, Wally. Ms. McDermott?
I agree that we want to be a cool county and we want to be environmentally sensitive. However, I'm a little bit concerned about voting for something where it says the county board hereby acknowledges a commitment to the Illinois Cool Counties program. I can't vote to commit to the Illinois Cool Counties program until someone tells me what the Cool Counties program entails. Maybe it's something that I love, maybe it's something that's not useful or appropriate for Will County. I don't know that as I sit here today. I'd like to know what I'm committing to before I vote for it. That's it.
Right.
Thank you.
And absolutely positively, this will be addressed in the committee. This isn't the place to give you the information that you need to have, but I will just simply say that it is in this context essentially a recognition program that because we're doing what we're doing, this particular community group says we're willing to have you join the brother and sisterhood.
Well, we got a motion and a second to send back committee. Any further discussion? Previous roll by Ms. Zagrosi, second by Mr. Ferry. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried. Thank you, Kurt.
That concludes my business. Our next meeting is May 14th. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Weigel. Next committee is Finance Committee. Mr. Wilhelmy, Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Executive. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Steve.
I hope everybody brought their waiters for the way home today. I don't have much of a report, but I do have four reports to put on file. First one is from the Illinois Department of Revenue showing sales tax remitted to Will County for February of 2013 of $1,244,646. In RTA tax revenue of $1,531,801 for a total of $2,776,448. I also have three reports from the Treasurer, Steve Weber, an amendment to the January 31st report and the monthly and quarterly reports for the period ended February 28, 2013, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Wilhelmy, second by Mr. Babich. Any discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary, motion is carried.
Thank you very much, everybody. And again, have a great day, and we'll see you in a month. Our next meeting is May 7th. Thank you
very much, Steve. Moving on to the Public Works and Transportation Committee. Mr. Adamick, Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Executive, and good morning, fellow
board
members.
Good morning,
Wally. We have 10 resolutions to present to you today. The first one is 1388, a resolution confirming an award of contract to Gallagher Asphalt Corporation in the amount of $748,162.99 for Indiana Avenue from Ashland to Illinois 1 and Pauline Goodenow Grove from Crete Monee Township Line to Illinois 1 and County Board District 1 using the County Board road bond funds, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Adamick, second by Mr. Howard. Any questions? Previous round by Mr. Babbage, second by Mr. Bible. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
Our second resolution is Resolution 1389, supplemental resolution for improvements by the county under Illinois Highway Code for various highways in the county using the motor fuel tax funds in the amount of $45,885.54, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Adamick, second by Mr. Moran. Any questions? Previous roll by Ms. Freitag, second by Mr. Gould. All in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary, motion is carried.
Resolution 1390 is an ordinance authorizing approval of establishment of an altered speed zone from Hadley Road to Telvale Court to South Brentwood Court for a half mile and proposed speed limit of 40 miles an hour in County Board District 6 and 8, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Adamick, second by Mr. Gould. Question, wait until I get a second. Second by Ms. Rice. Question, Mr. Gould.
District 7, Homer Township.
Think so? Okay. Well, we'll have to, we'll check on it. We'll have Melissa check on it and we'll be back.
Thank you.
Thank you for the information, Don. So we have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? Previous roll by Mr. Bible, second by Mr. Trainier. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
Resolution 1391 is a resolution authorizing intergovernmental agreement between the County of Will and the City of Joliet for improvements to McDonough Street, County Highway 3, between Hobolt Road and Infantry Drive in the City of Joliet, County Board Districts 8 and 10, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Adamick, second by Mr. Babbage. Any questions? Previous roll call by Ms. Goodson, second by Ms. Freitag. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
Fifth resolution is Resolution 1392, a resolution for supplemental construction engineering services by the county under Illinois Highway Code with Patrick Engineering for Indiana Avenue over Trim Creek and County Board District 1 using road bonds or RTA tax funds in the amount of $18,597.18, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Adamick, second by Mr. Howard. Any questions? Previous roll by Ms. Rice, second by Ms. Trainier. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
Resolution 1393 is a resolution for supplemental construction engineering services by the county with ACOM Technical Services for Weber Road, County Highway 88, between Gaskin Drive and Airport Road, County Board Districts 13 and 3, using county road bonds or RTA tax funds in the amount of $194,704.10, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Adamick, second by Mr. Harris. Any questions? Previous roll call by Mr. Ferry, second by Ms. Goodson. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion carried.
Resolution 1394 is a resolution authorizing the approval of professional services supplemental agreement for engineering services with A. Epstein and Sons International for Bell Road at the intersection of 143rd Street, County Highway 37, County Board District 7, using the road bond funds or RTA tax funds in the amount of $92,179.66, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Adamick, second by Mr. Frisalone. Question, Mr. Weigel?
Yes, in the packet, it talks about installing a detention tank. I assume this is for stormwater. Is this a normal practice to install detention tanks, and how large is it?
I'll refer to our county highway engineer.
Mr. Gould, please.
Morning, everyone.
Morning.
In this particular case, this is something new that we're doing for this project.
The problem is, because of the size of this intersection project, we have limited right-of-way to have any piping or any open ditch drainage, so we have to do an encased drainage in accordance with our stormwater management ordinance throughout the county. So this is something different that we've not done before, but because of the situation up there, it's something that's required.
How many gallons is it?
Off the top of my head, I can't tell you, but I can give you that information.
They'll just hold it temporarily and then drain off?
Absolutely. What it is, it's basically a detention pond that's subsurface.
Any other questions for Mr. Gould? Thank you very much, Chris.
You're welcome.
Okay. Any further discussion? Motion previous roll call by Ms. Winfrey, second by Mr. Wilhelmy. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
Resolution 1395 is a resolution authorizing approval of professional services agreement for engineering services with Parsons Brinkerhoff for Bell Road. Between 159th and 151st Street in County Board District 7, using the road bond funds or RTA tax funds in the amount of $1,035,380.49, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Adamick, seconded by Mr. Harris. Any questions? Previous roll call by Ms. Goodson, seconded by Ms. Collins. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
Resolution 1396 is a resolution adopting the five-year transportation improvement program known as the WIL Transportation Improvement Program for year 2013 through 2018. This is something we do on a yearly basis, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Adamick, second by Mr. Babbage. Questions?
Yes.
Question, Ms. McDermott.
At our caucus this morning, we talked extensively about this resolution and would ask that it be remanded to finance and to capital improvements. What this resolution appears to be doing, to the best of our ability to analyze it, is remove the RTA funds from consideration for any other uses before finance or capital improvement has a chance to discuss it or consider it. And we're asking that it be sent back to those committees so that use of these funds can be discussed more thoroughly and prioritized more completely. And I so move that it be remanded.
You make a motion?
I'm moving that it be remanded to finance
back.
And capital improvement.
Moved by Ms. McDermott, second by Mr. Isel. Any further discussion on the motion? Who's got a question? Mr. Howard?
Is there any time mechanism on this as far as is this a requirement for a grant process or anything or use of RTA?
Mr. Gould, would you like to come forward and explain our procedure that we've had for years?
Morning again. In accordance with Illinois revised statutes, the state statutes, we are required to do a long-term planning in the county, 20-year program. As part of the 20-year program, there is also a five-year component to the 20-year program for the current 5 years that shows all the projects that we'd be moving forward in that year, in those 5 years. Statute also says that shall be updated on a yearly basis. This is similar to what IDOT does with their multi-year program. Every year, they have public hearings, have the multi-year program, similar to the Collar Counties in the state of Illinois with Cook County. So that's what we're doing. There's not any time frame that the statute says it shall be adopted at a certain time, but we're doing this in accordance with the statutes, as we have.
Questions, anyone? Mr. Wilhelmy.
Yeah, Bruce, aren't we already kind of committed based on engineering work and some of the preliminary work to expend a good chunk of this money over the next 5 years? I mean, if we back off now, it's going to put a damper on what we've already done.
Well, if I could make a comment to that, and it brings up a good point. I made an explanation at our Public Works and Transportation Committee concerning the five-year plan. And Commissioner Gould brought up, well, what happens if the RTA or if some funds are deleted from this program? I said, well, whatever's deleted, then we have to revise the program to show that. So right now, in my budget, in the 2013 budget, we show 100% of that in my highway budget, in the 40 code. Now, if that has been is reduced in any way, then that will be reflected on my five-year plan in the future.
Any other, Mr. Brooks?
I do understand that these discussions are made in committee, and normally you're there, Mr. Gould, to answer any of those questions. And moreover, the committee meetings are open to all 26 of us to discuss those things. So I guess this brings up concern to me, is that the time to discuss them is in committee, and if we're not there to discuss it, my concern is, too, the timeline as well. Will this hold up any projects? I thought by bringing this to this committee, we were prepared to move forward with this five-year plan.
Well, all I can say to that, obviously, I have my budget for 2013, mm-hmm. and I'm working off that budget that shows 100% of the RTA fund.
Well my question, if this is sent back to committee for one more month, would it affect anything?
No, it would not.
Mr. Mustis?
Part of my question is already answered, and that is the 2013 part of the program is funded. But I do think it should be sent back, and I do think the Finance Committee and the Capital Improvements Committee, but more specifically the Finance Committee, should always review this. Because what this resolution does is it commits revenues without ever going through the Finance Committee.
You adopt a program, and therefore you're adopting the funding, and this should always go through Finance. Always should have. You know, and quite frankly, you know, I put this a little bit on myself, should have done it in the past.
Yeah.
Certainly, what we did is we also reduced the highway levy a number of years ago, so it was a little bit of a switch. The corporate fund didn't go down one penny, but the highway got $5 million less out of the corporate levy.
That's correct. Yeah, in 2009, so, the levies
which
were reduced.
Which really allowed then for $5 million additional to go into operations, which really then you could say RTA money wound up in operations indirectly. That's not for you, Bruce. This is more of a statement. But for those of you who don't understand, you know, we can make decisions to put it back into the corporate levy. There is other discussions that need to take place at the Finance Committee. And finance matters shouldn't be decided in public works. That's really the issue. And that's what happened in the past. And, you know, I'll put that on me a little bit because I was there, but I'm just telling you that this should not be, Finance Committee should not be bypassed when you're making significant decisions on where revenues go. That's all I'm saying. So I do think it should go back to Finance. Thank you.
Mr. Grossi, wait till.
Okay, thanks. I would only ask that you consider the fact that this is part of the grander scheme of things in the Build Well program. So that was laid out. There is priorities that have been already set out there for us to go ahead and take under consideration. It is in the budget already. So we're almost at a point now where we are committed to that because those are budgeted funds out there.
For one year only.
Mr. Grossi's got the floor.
Okay, this is for 1 year only, Jim. Not
for 5 years.
Yes. Okay, Bruce, clarify for me. You said you have to go back and you have to redo this each year, correct?
Correct.
So this is a rolling from 2013 to 2018. However, next year, and again, when budget time comes up, and that's probably when this needs to be addressed, it will then be reevaluated again if those funds are then taken back. This date now is going to be a rolling, so now it's going to go from 2014 to 2019.
That is correct.
Okay.
Mr. Howard?
Again, I have to commend Bruce on the job that he does, and we do have to have a plan for 5 years. I mean, we have to have a 5-year look ahead, and apparently this is what this is. And each year we are allowed to, either we're going to budget the money or we're not. Correct, Mr.?
That is correct.
So, I mean, there's nothing wrong with planning for the future, and I think that we should move forward with this.
Mr. Atmink?
If for the future we want to take this to finance, that's fine. But at this point, the horse has already left the station, and we've already went through the committee process. If people have a problem with how the committee process is going or have questions, come to the committee. We've had this happen now with the previous resolution in Cool Counties, and now this. Come to the committees. That's why we have a committee process. The work gets done in committees, not trying to change it on the board floor. And I agree to some extent with Mr. Moussa about the financial issues, but still, it's already too late. It's in the committee. Let's move forward. And for next year, if we want to come to finance, then come to finance, and then the public works. I'd like to see this move forward.
Mr. Mistis, did you have a comment or question?
Here again, the 2013 part of it is already committed, is already done. I do think when you pass this resolution, you're committing all the RTA funds. Now, I understand that it can be changed in any budget year, but what if I made a motion to say, you know, this commits all the funds? What if I wanted to amend it and say no more than 50% of the RTA funds will ever be used for in this plan? I mean, you make the suggestion that all the RTA funds, believe me, you'll come back and you'll say this has already been committed. Are you going to really think you're going to cut a road program as it goes along? I doubt it. I'm very supportive of roads. We're talking about how those roads get financed and whether it goes out of the RTA funds, whether it comes out of the corporate levy, or any other resources we have. I have an objection to basically passing a resolution that basically says you're going to commit all the RTA funds. I'll ask Mr. Gould. Mr. Gould, when you said here's the revenue sources, did you take 100% of the RTA revenues?
Yes, I did.
Okay. I don't, that's my concern, and I believe the concern of my caucus is that, you know, we need to have a discussion, finance needs to have a discussion, and this board needs to understand all the capital needs of Will County, not just the road capital needs. So I since it doesn't hurt anything, what does it hurt for it to go back to? It doesn't stop anything. There's no time frame on adopting this. Why not have a more thorough discussion on how revenues are going to be used? Why not let the Capital Improvements Committee come out and let us, who's having workshops, so they can also put out what other capital needs the county is in need of and what they feel should go forward. Why not let the Finance Committee do the financing of the county and not the Public Works Committee? That's the issue. And I readily say that I understand that this has maybe been a little part of the past practice. And I've been there, and it just, you know, but as I gave it more thought, no, there needs to be a more thorough discussion. So if it doesn't hurt anything, and Mr. Gould said there's no time frame, why wouldn't we have a further discussion? That's all I have to say.
Mr. Howard?
Mr. Gould, does this bring us into state compliance then with the law, with the state statute?
Well, not at this point if we don't pass the 5-year plan.
But if we pass it, it brings us in compliance with state statute?
Well, sure.
Okay. And again, this can fall under budgetary process next year, where it'll be, you'll come with, well, course, with another plan.
That brings up a good point, because I am now working on the 2014 budget. I'm working that up right now. I have to submit that to the finance director at the end of next month. So I'm working on those numbers right now. Obviously, there's going to be some revisions to that budget, but I have to work off of what I have today. I don't know what to anticipate in the future until this board allows me.
Mr. Mistis?
One other point I think I should make is this board at no time ever passed a resolution saying 100% of the RTA funds would go to roads. This board passed a resolution basically stating the RTA funds would be used only for capital projects since the state statute allowed it to be used for operations for public safety. We wanted to make it clear it would only be used for capital projects. At no time did this board ever say 100% would be used for roads. And it just became an assumption that it was used. This board never said this is going to be the revenue stream. I don't want to, in some ways, I don't know how this even occurred. It just happened. It was an assumption that, the highway will take, all the money will be budgeted, and we'll cut the corporate dollars away from highway, and we'll give them the RTA. You know, I know the board approved the cut in that corporate levy for the highway, but it doesn't mean it can't be reestablished. This is the point. The point is the board never approved this. The board never said this is how those funds would be 100% exclusively used. So I don't even know how it happened. Who made that decision? I mean, who made the decision all the money would go to highway on an operational basis? We only committed to that bond issue, which took about $8 million of that revenue stream. When did this board ever approve or say all the highway funds would go? Those funds can be used for two purposes, public safety and highway. Whoever made the decision would all go to highway. I don't think those funds were ever committed by this board, ever. That's the other issue, by the way. So who made that decision?
If I could just make Ms. one. No, I didn't make. No. No.
No. Ms. Trainer.
100% the revenue stream. The only thing that was committed out of those funds was that bond issue. That was the only thing this board ever approved.
Ms. Trainer.
Thank you, Mr. Executive. This board made a decision in December when it passed a budget, and that process goes on every year. And as far as, in my view, what decisions this board makes. We can make some new decisions in the future if we choose to do that. But that hadn't been brought up prior to this committee and prior to passing the five-year plan that we have in front of us today. This board is a brand new board. Every 2 years we have an election process and we get a new board. And every year we get a new budget. So every year we have the opportunity to determine where the county wants to spend its funds. I think we made that decision by approving this five-year transportation plan in committee.
Mr. Bible?
Mr. Executive, I just wanted to know how historically we have used RTA funds. Have they not exclusively been used to improve roads in the past, and now we're talking about doing something different with them? I just want that as a point of information.
The revenue that has come from the RTA has gone to the bonding program, which $8.5 million for 20 years is the first payment out of the RTA money, and the rest has been allocated for road projects. We bring down Finance Paul Rafak. Would you like to come down? Maybe you can shed just a little bit clearer on both the history, and
if I could clarify
go ahead, Bruce.
Something too,
Bruce,
if
Bruce.
I could, please.
Yeah, let Bruce make a comment there. Yeah.
As far as there's, I'd just like to make a clarification. There's been some comment made about corporate funding in that. My highway budget receives no money from the corporate account. I want to say that. I don't take any funds from the corporate. There's no percentage from the corporate. What Mr. Musis, when he was talking about the reduction in my budget back in 2009 when the RTA tax started, was from the two special levies, which is the federal matching levy and the county bridge levy. And those levies were reduced approximately $5 million at that time. The levy still remains. We haven't reduced it to zero. If we did that, you'd have to go through special referendum to bring that back. So we still have those two levies, but just a minuscule amount of money is put towards it. And when I say that, I'm talking, as far as the matching fund is concerned, this year's levy was $22,000. So it's just a small amount to keep that levy open so that we don't reduce it to zero, because then we would have a problem. We'd have to go back through referendum to get that back. Correct, Paul?
Yes, that's correct. We reduced the, on October 14th, 2008, the Finance Committee adjusted the two levies by 2.1 and roughly 2.1 and shifted that money to be spent out of the RTA tax. All of the money for the RTA fund has been committed to date and spent to date on road projects. This plan doesn't commit funds. What commits funds is the resolutions that were passed. You just passed, prior to this issue, four or five resolutions totaling $1.4 million that continues to commit RTA funds going forward. So you're committing funds not through this resolution, which presents a plan. You're committing funds through the resolutions that are passed at Public Works. So the question that I would ask, if you're intending that all commitments of funds now go through the Finance Committee, then I think you probably have to change the Public Works process as well, because Public Works is constantly committing funds and those things are not going through the Finance Committee. It seems like, and there are occasionally other committees that commit funds. So you may have to change your whole structure if you really want anything that has a dollar amount attached to it to go through finance. But this thing is just a plan. And we've passed in prior years five-year plans. This adds one new year to the plan.
Thank you. Ms. Rice, comment?
I want to support this going forward today, this resolution, and I would really welcome discussion such as you just proposed in the future, and I think it is important. But I want to look at today's plan moving forward, or, you know, going to vote moving forward, and then discussing our process and how it can be improved to prevent things such as you suggested from happening.
Okay. Mr. Howard?
Paul, can you just repeat the last couple paragraphs you just said it about changing the whole process?
Many of our committees commit funds without going through finance. They then come to the executive committee. The executive committee approves it. Then it comes to the full board. Prior to this resolution, there were multiple commitments just out of Public Works that committed the use of funds to do these road projects. So if you want to change that process, I think you need to look at it in a very macro way, because it's not uncommon for us to commit the use of funds out of health and aging, out of judicial. So we need to think about all of these things. Sometimes they also do parallel track and go through the Finance Committee, but not always. So that's a big change in operating, and it's not what we've done for the eight and a half years I've been here. But, well, you know, we constantly change how we do things. That's maybe a good thing, maybe it's not. I don't know.
Mr. Wilhelmy?
Yes, I just wanted to ask Bruce again, the Build Will program that we all touted over the last 4 or 5 years, would that be in jeopardy if we did not utilize the RTA funds?
If you don't use any of the RTA funds?
Or are we starting reducing it?
The Build Will program would expand out to multiple years.
We all said we wanted to spend $300 million on road program. As far as committing funds, Mr. Moussas, I think that was committed right there.
And yeah, total is $357 million, 72 projects at this point in time. That's what the Build Will program
exactly.
shows.
Exactly. Without the use of the RTA funds, I don't think that program is going to continue, and not at the speed that we had wanted it to be. So,
Mr. Weigel?
You, Paul, you mentioned that we approved these prior resolutions. Weren't they in his budget already for this year, this money that we
assuming
approved?
Assuming that you're going to use bond funds and road funds and matching grant funds, yes, they're already in there. However, they okay. are multiple-year projects. I don't believe that all of these projects will be completed in this construction cycle. So the last one on that list, the million-dollar project, I don't know that that'll be done this year, which means it'll extend into next year. And the Buildwell project was for $357 million mm-hmm. in road work. Only $100 million of that was coming from grants and maybe, from the bonds, and maybe $60 million was coming from matching from federal and other sources. So we've continued and we extended from that initial 60 projects to 72 projects just this past year with resolution 12-321. So we have continued to move forward with those things. And when we let this work, it is not 1 year of work. It's often multiple years of work. Roads don't get done in one construction cycle. So we have continued to commit to into the future and to spend those funds into the future.
I think we're looking at a bigger picture here, a five-year plan, and we have other county needs. Talking about a courthouse and a sheriff station, I think we need to look down the road a bit and not just commit the RTA funds for 5 years. And it appears that's the way the plan is scheduled, and I think it should be looked at by other committees, the finance and the capital. I'm not sure that all these roads need to be four lanes. Like Laraway Road, we're spending a couple $100 million to make it four lanes. I don't know that that needs to be four lanes in the next 10 years, maybe 20 years from now, but not necessarily right now.
Mr. Bible?
I call for the question, Mr. Executive.
Okay. Got two more speakers. Oh, that was your call, Ms. Goodson?
Just referring back to earlier in the discussion, you know, I just want to say that part of the reason why we made such a huge commitment towards the Buildwell program was because our roads were in such disrepair, because we were so far behind in infrastructure needs due to the enormous growth that we were experiencing. The RTA tax was passed at a time when we really had a difficult time attracting state and federal dollars for these needed road projects. We made a very strong commitment towards repairing and upgrading our county roads, which I guess also went hand in hand with many of the jobs that we were able to create by committing to this program. And I think that part of our discussion in committee this morning was because of our recent tours, which several of us went on, of our judicial needs and our sheriff department needs. And so I understand the need to go back and revisit our commitment to the dollar amount for our road projects, but I do think it's important that we continue to address our needs for infrastructure.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, there's a motion on the floor by Ms. McDermott to remand this, send this back to committee, and evidently that is the committee, to Finance Committee specifically, and Capital Improvements Committee. So the motion is to send this resolution 1397 back to Finance and Capital. What?
1396.
Oh, 1396. Sorry, 1396. Back to Capital and Improvements. Madam Clerk, call the roll.
Mustis?
Yes.
Howard?
No.
Ogala?
Yes.
Izzo?
Yes.
Moran?
No.
Rice?
No.
Harris?
No.
Trainier?
No.
Bible?
No.
Goodson?
Yes.
Freitag?
Yes.
Gould?
Yes.
Balich?
Yes.
Frisalone?
Yes.
Winfrey?
No.
Adamek?
No.
Babich?
No.
Wilhelmy?
No.
McDermott?
Yes.
Weigel?
Yes.
Collins?
Yes.
Ferry?
No.
Brooks?
No.
Thank you.
12 affirmative, 12 negative.
12. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12.
13 to 11.
Yeah.
13 to 11.
Yeah, let's.
13 no, 11
affirmative. Yes. Motion is died. Mr. Adamek, your motion to move forward. Madam Clerk, call the roll.
Zagrozzi?
Yes.
Mustis?
No.
Howard?
Yes.
Ogala?
No.
Izzo?
No.
Moran?
Yes.
Rice?
Yes.
Harris?
Yes.
Trainier?
Yes.
Bible?
Yes.
Goodson?
No.
Freitag?
No.
Gould?
No.
Balich?
No.
Grisalone?
No.
Winfrey?
Yes.
Adamek?
Yes.
Babich?
Yes.
Wilhelmie?
No.
McDermott?
No.
Weigel?
No.
Collins?
No.
Ferry?
Yes.
And Brooks?
Yes.
Thirteen negative?
No.
13 positive.
13 positive votes. Motion has carried. Mr. Adamek, continue.
Our final resolution was Resolution 1397,
Resolution authorizing agreement for east use of easement over lands and common vessels in the roadway reconstruction. I'm sorry, Mr. Adamek. Moved by Mr. Adamek, seconded by Mr. Ferry. Any discussion? Madam Clerk, call the roll.
Zagrozzi?
Yes.
Mustis?
Yes.
Howard?
Yes.
Ogala?
Yes.
Izzo?
Yes.
Moran?
Yes.
Rice?
Yes.
Harris?
Yes.
Trainier?
Yes.
Bible?
Yes.
Goodson?
Yes.
Freitag?
Yes.
Gould?
Yes.
Balich?
Yes.
Grisalone?
Yes.
Winfrey? Adamek?
Yes.
Babich?
Yes.
Wilhelmie?
Yes.
McDermott?
Yes.
Weigel?
Yes.
Collins?
Yes.
Ferry?
Yes.
And Brooks?
Yes.
Yeah. 23 affirmative, 0 negative, 1 abstain.
23 affirmative. Motion is carried.
Thank you, Mr. Sherman. That concludes my report. Our next scheduled meeting is for May 7th at 8:30 a.m., and I'd like to remind all of our members and also those that are watching today that it's been a pretty wet day today, and to be careful on the roadways with a lot of the standing water, so for their safety. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Wally. Ms. DeGrossi.
Yes, just a point of order, if I could. On item number 13-90, that is District 7.
That is what?
District 7.
Oh, District 7.
Yes.
Okay.
All right.
Melissa will handle that.
We'll make sure the word that's
yep.
correct.
Yep.
It should be 6 and 7.
Yep.
6 and 7.
Yep. Thank you. Thank you, Diane. Next on our agenda, the Judicial Committee, Mr. Bible.
Mr. Executive and Madam Clerk and all board members, the Judicial Committee conducted, in lieu of a meeting last month, a two consecutive day tour of our law enforcement and judicial facilities, and I think it's not overstating it that the majority of those who participated found these facilities to be either overcrowded or an advanced state of deterioration, or both, and in need, serious need of either repair or extensive renovation. For the rest of the report from the Judicial Committee, I would like to yield to the Vice Chair of that committee, Mr. David Izzo.
Thank you, Mr. Bible. I wonder, Mr. Izzo.
Well,
maybe I'll just talk like this.
Yeah, usually ends.
I wonder.
Usually ends.
I wonder if this would be an opportune time at this point in time to maybe
yes,
make a presentation.
Yes, it is. That's where we were going on, but okay.
You want me to go first or go second?
Well, you got a report to give?
Yes, I do.
You give your report.
Thank you. We had an opportunity to hear a presentation.
Can you talk into Leanne's mic, maybe?
We had an opportunity to talk. We had an opportunity to have a presentation by Ms. Julie McCabe-Stirr of the Will County State's Attorney Drug, Mental Health, and Veteran Courts Program. She touted the success of the program. She recently informed us that we had over 300 graduates of the program within the last several months, which was phenomenal. I thought the presentation was quite informative. I think most telling from that presentation was the pictures she showed us, the mugshots she showed us of individuals who had participated in this program, the before and after photographs, which were quite amazing. So the only other thing that Ms. McCabe-Stirr indicated to me at that time or to the committee at that time is she wanted to thank the county board for its continued support. That's all I have to report. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Izzum. Anything else, Mr. Bible, other than our presentation?
Next meeting of the Judicial Committee will be at 8:30 on May the 7th.
Okay, so we do have a presentation that Waste Management is here to present a check to the Juvenile Drug Court Program. So Jim and Julie and Lee, everybody, read Bible. Dale, you can get in here too. If you oh, you better get in. You better get in.
We needed him. County Executive Walsh, County Board members, State's Attorney Glasgow, good morning. I'm Lee Adelman, and I'm joined today by Dale Hoekstra, who is the Director of Midwest Landfill Operations, to present a check to the Juvenile Drug Court Program. More than 30 years ago, Waste Management adopted a hiring policy for new hires that required them to go through both a psychological screening and a medical exam. This is very important because with 46,000 employees in North America, fully three-quarters of those employees operate either collection vehicles, heavy equipment, or trucks of some nature. No one wants any of these operators to be impaired in any way through substance abuse. So concurrent with that policy, they also adopted a random drug screening program. I bring this up because, unfortunately, a fair number of the applicants for work at Waste Management fail this initial step. And therefore, it's a concern for all of us. We're not about to turn the keys over to a $400,000 collection vehicle to someone who's impaired or an operator of a heavy equipment such as an 800,000 bulldozer to a person who's engaged in substance abuse. Because we seem to be in a culture that glorifies the use of mind-altering substances, and we just had a recent vote in the Illinois legislature, it's apparent that this is enticing to the youth of our culture. And that's a concern for all of us. So one who starts down that path as a young person will probably at some point run afoul of the law enforcement agencies. And when they do, they end up in the court system. We're all firm believers in a second chance for individuals who make a mistake. They have a life choice to make. They can join society and be a willing and an important contributor, or they can continue that spiral downward that all drug abuse tends to accommodate. So we have been supporters of the Juvenile Drug Court Program for a number of years now. We urge other corporations in this county to join us in supporting them. And I think it's a great credit to Will County that you have this program in place, that the State's Attorney Glasgow and Julie McCabe-Stirr so admirably and effectively administer. And so we are supporters and great participants in that program. Thank you very much.
Should give it to Jim.
It's quite an honor to have Lee Edelman come all the way back from Costa Rica from his catbird seat overlooking the ocean. But Waste Management has been a great partner with this county. Obviously, the landfill is couldn't be run in a more seamless fashion. All the terrifying rumors that were started when we were doing this process didn't come to pass. It's a reputable company, and they do a great job. And every year, they step up with a contribution for the drug court, which is sorely needed. Obviously, the juvenile drug court, if we can catch kids at that young age and turn them around, then we don't see them in adult drug court, where it's a lot tougher. He talked about young people wanting to use drugs or having a proclivity. You know, Lee, when you and I were kids, stuff wasn't around. That's the difference. I mean, as adolescents, we're always exploring, wanting to push the limits. The trouble is, when you push the limits with some of these drugs, you can't get back. You know, tomorrow we've got our second annual conference at Lewis University on the heroin epidemic. And although the first 3 months we started out with only 3 overdoses, we've spiked up to 12 now. And we're on the same pace we were last year for 53. So, you know, we thought maybe the word had gotten out and maybe we had turned the corner, but we haven't. So this check, it means a lot. It'll go to a very good program that hopefully can help us stem this tide and get kids educated at a very early age so they understand the dangers. Waste Management, thank you.
I want to thank the County Board for always being there to support these programs. Our juvenile drug court program, the adult drug court, our mental health court, our veterans court, you have been there behind our recovery homes and with us 100%. The juvenile drug court is 100% supported by donations. It is not supported by county funds, and without Waste Management doing these kinds of things, we wouldn't be able to provide the services that we do. So thank you, Waste Management, and thank you, County Board.
If you don't mind, I'd like to add that in 25 years, I've attended almost every board meeting in Will County. This is the first time I've ever driven here wearing scuba gear. Thanks a lot.
Well, thank you very much, Lee and Dale. We really appreciate your continued support for Will County. Thank you. Okay, moving on. We are at the Public Health and Safety Committee. Mr. Babbage, Chairman.
Good morning, Mr. Executive and fellow County Board members.
Good morning, Joe.
Today we have no resolution to bring forward. Our next meeting will be May 9th at 8:30.
Thank you very much, Joe.
That concludes my report.
Thank you. Fine report. Next, we on to the Insurance and Personnel Committee. Ms. Zagrosi, Chairperson.
This morning, ladies and gentlemen, we have one resolution, 13-98, which is a resolution adopting the charitable organization policy, and I so move.
Moved by Ms. Zagrosi, second by Mr. Ferry. Any questions? Any questions? Previous roll call by Mr. Izzo, second by Ms. Troynier. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion has carried.
Okay, and our next meeting is scheduled for May 14th at 9:30, and hope everyone can make time in their schedule to please attend.
Thank you, Diane. Next, we move on to Legislative and Policy Committee. Mr. Howard, Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Executive. We have no resolutions to bring forth this morning. Our next meeting is May 14, 2013, 8:30 a.m. And also, there currently is quite a few legislative items downstate that we're monitoring, and then we'll bring those forth to the Legislative and Policy Committee. And I'd also like to remind everyone this is tornado season. out there. Actually, as I was driving in today, we almost seen a couple funnel clouds actually start developing. So education and awareness is important with the weather right now. And I wish everybody a safe passage back home. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Next, we move on to the Capital Improvements Committee. Ms. Winfrey, chairperson.
Good morning, Mr. Executive,
good morning,
fellow board
Denise.
Members. Capital Improvements has one resolution to bring forward today, that is 1399, and it's a resolution directing the Public Building Commission to fund and assist in the management of the emergency repairs of the Will County Health Department, and I so move.
Moved by Ms. Winfrey, second by Mr. Ferry. Any questions? Any questions? Previous roll call by Mrs. Grossi, second by Ms. Rice. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion has carried.
Additionally, the Capital Improvements Committee will do a workshop on May 21st and 22nd, beginning at 10 each day and carrying on till approximately 12:30, 1 o'clock, to look at all the capital projects in the county and figure out what needs to happen for those. That will be at the Joliet Black Road Library for Capital Improvement Committee members. Our next regularly scheduled meeting will be May 7th, 10 o'clock. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Denise. Next, we move on to the Executive Committee. Mr. Brooks, chairperson.
Good morning, Mr. Executive.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning. The first resolution I have is 13-100, resolution authorizing the county exec to execute Workforce Investment Board Memorandum of Understanding with ABT Associates Incorporated through the Health Professional Opportunity Grant, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Brooks, second by Mr. Grossi. Any questions? Previous roll call by Ms. Trenier, second by Ms. Goodson. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
Second one, 13-101, resolution authorizing the county exec to renew and modify Workforce Investment Board contract with the College of Lake County through Health Professional Opportunity Grant to reflect modified grant amount, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Brooks, second by Mr. Adamick. Any questions? Previous roll call by Ms. Winfrey, second by Mr. Moran. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion has carried.
Next one, 13-102, resolution authorizing the county exec to renew and modify Workforce Investment Board contract with the Central State SCR Jobs for Progress Incorporated through Health Professions Opportunity Grant to reflect modified grant amount, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Brooks, second by Ms. Freitag. Any questions? Previous roll by Mr. Bible, second by Mr. Harris. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion has carried.
13-103, resolution authorizing county exec to execute intergovernment agreement for ombudsman services for Ileana Expressway, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Brooks, second by Ms. Winfrey. Any questions? Previous roll call by Mr. Harris, second by Mr. Babbage. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, Mr. Izzo? A no. Mr. Izzo is a no on that resolution. Thank you. Ms. Ogala will be a no. Thank you very much. Mr. Brooks, please.
13-104, replacement hires for Sunny Hill Nursing Home, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Brooks, second by Mr. Howard. Any questions? Previous roll by Mr. Babbage, second by Ms. Winfrey. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, Mr. Izzo, yes? Yes, Ms. Ogala, yes. Thank you very much.
Right.
Mr. Brooks.
13-105, replacement hires for the Highway Department, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Brooks, seconded by Mr. Moran. Any questions? Previous roll by Ms. Goodson, seconded by Ms. Rice. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion has carried.
13-106, replacement hire for new hire for the ICT Department, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Brooks, seconded by Mr. Babbage. Any questions? Previous roll by Mr. Bible, second by Ms. Winfrey. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
Next one, 13-107, resolution awarding bid for household hazardous waste collection, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Brooks, second by Mr. Frizzalone. Any questions? Previous roll by Mrs. Grossi, second by Mr. Balich. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
Next one is 13-108, resolution authorizing county exec to execute an intergovernmental agreement with the City of Naperville for operation of a household hazardous waste collection facility, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Brooks, second by Mr. Ferry. Any questions? Previous roll by Mr. Adamek, second by Ms. Goodson. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion is carried.
13-109, resolution authorized county exec to execute an intergovernmental agreement with New Lenox Township for one-day household hazardous waste collection event for the fall of 2013, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Brooks, second by Mr. Weigel. Any questions? Previous roll by Mr. Adamek, second by Mr. Harris. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion has carried.
And lastly, 13-110, resolution supporting nomination of Honorable James D. Healy to the National Freight Advisory Committee, and I so move.
Moved by Mr. Brooks, second by Mr. Adamek. Any questions? Previous roll call by Ms. Winfrey, second by Mr. Harris. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion has carried.
Our next executive committee is meeting scheduled for May the 2nd, 2013, 9:30 a.m., and I do invite all to attend. Appointments?
Yes,
appointments,
sir.
By the county exec, and you all have them. I so move.
Moved by Mr. Brooks, second by Mr. Adamek. Any questions? Previous roll call by Ms. Rice, second by Ms. Goodson. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Contrary, motion has carried. Abstain. Mr. Gould abstains on appointments. So moving on, announcements by our county speaker, Mr. Brooks.
Let me begin by thanking Waste Management, Lee Aderman and Dale Hoekstra, for the contribution they made to juvenile court. Waste Management certainly have been a good neighbor for us here at Will County, and I appreciate your contribution for a very important cause. But while I was here, sitting in the audience out there, and saw the 300-person graduate, I was very proud of those families were. But while I was sitting in the audience, I sat next to former county board member Andrell from Lamont. And Elle and Ann leaned over and asked me to ask the county board members this question. Who is the next person on the county board to step up and take her place of working with Julie and the drug court? And you can submit the name to Julie. Secondly, and that was a wonderful program, congratulations. Secondly, the Stormwater Committee have asked us, all of our district, just a reminder for appointments to that committee, and they need those names as soon as possible. Who? Nick Palmer? Okay, that goes you, Nick? Okay. Then Nick needs as soon as possible. And then lastly, as you all know, we've had storms today. It's been mentioned. It's so good to see everybody outside of our county seat. Joliet to show up this morning. I know many of us wait for our caucus and for the meeting, but that just tells us on the way out of Joliet, be very careful. There is still a lot of flooding going on. However, if you decide to stay in the beautiful city of Champions, we sure give you a tour of all the rivers on today. Thank you all, and have a safe weekend.
Thank you, Mr. Brooks. Next, the Democratic Caucus Chair, Ms. Grossi.
Thank you, Mr. Walsh and fellow board members. I'm going to make it very brief. We have so much to be thankful for, the things that are going on in this county and the achievements of this board moving forward, and I say that uniformly. We're doing a lot of very good things. We will maintain our focus as we go forward. We do know, obviously, that we're not always going to agree 100% of the time, but I think we all do know when we walk away from our desks that we all have a very healthy respect for each other and what we stand for. I believe Herb was good enough to already mention, as did several people, the weather conditions out there are a little treacherous. There is expected to be more rain coming. It's not letting up for the next couple days, so expect more road conditions to be somewhat severe. Do tune to your local weather channel. I know when I was on my way in this morning, JOL had a very good listing that they were updating constantly as far as road closures and so forth. So just to everyone, have a good day and stay safe.
Thank you, Diane. Next, the Republican Caucus Chair, Mr. Mustis.
Good morning, Mr. Executive.
Good morning, Jim.
First, let me start by saying that our thoughts and prayers are certainly with the folks out in Boston. It's a tragic thing, but I know one thing about Americans: the more you try to intimidate them, the less intimidated they become. So it doesn't work, and whether it's homegrown or international, it doesn't have the effect that they sometimes think they're going to get. So, but our prayers and thoughts are certainly with the folks out in Boston. April showers bring May flowers. What do April monsoons bring? You know, our Naperville representatives aren't here today because they said they were flooded in. They couldn't. The bridge was closed. Their streets were flooded. I mean, so certainly everyone. I don't know. Hopefully, it'll dry up, Larry, so the farmers get out in those fields someday, right? So everyone, be careful. Road closures. Try to keep your travel to a minimum. And once again, I appreciate all the hard work everyone does. I appreciate all the work of the committees. And it always makes me feel good when we have a little lively debate. So thank you, everyone, and we'll see you next month.
Thanks. You, Jim. We will be going into executive session for a very brief presentation by the state's attorney. So 5 or 10 minutes break here so everybody can get out. Our camera people can get closed up. And so in about 10 minutes, we'll be back here for executive session. So please stick around. Yeah.